up, you guys? EF Rice Rods back here with another bike video for you. Time to finish up this project, and you can probably notice that our other member, Ben, is not with us. He's not too much of a big bike guy, so we're just going to go ahead and continue with the project anyways. He'll be back in another video soon enough. So, the deal with the brakes. I tried to do the front brake pads and the rotors, and I found out that this bike has 2001 to 2006 CBR front and rear wheels, so someone upgraded the rims on it, which is awesome, but I didn't know about it, and I think the previous owner didn't know about it, because I think it's been owned by a few people. So I had to go through the long process of paying to ship out the rotors back, and then getting the refund, and then ordering the new ones, and then getting them to my house. So it's been a long time coming to get this thing back on the road, because it's been pretty nice out. And let's get started. All right, so we're gonna start by removing this wheel again. If you didn't see me remove the rear rotor and the front rotors and the brake pads on the wheel, check out the last video for that. I am going to be doing it again, but just pretty much with the installation process. So what you want to do is take off that axle nut. Do that here, 22 millimeter. Sides. Like that. I should be able to hammer out. Forget to take the rotors off, or the calipers off. There it is. Time to get the rotor on. So here we got the new rotors. It's this box. There it is. Much better. Definitely much, much better. Now that should be the right lug pattern. I hope. Whew! Looks like it lines up. That is so relieving. That's been sitting up in my house for like 3 days because it's been pouring rain and I haven't had a chance to do it. And I was really hoping these were the right rotors. Going through that process, thinking that they shipped me the wrong stuff, me realizing that I didn't actually know what I had on my bike, it's been kind of a nightmare. So let's get these new rotors right on. 6 millimeter. So we're gonna put some that medium strength thread locker on there, Permatex blue. These puppies right in. You also want to tighten these in a star pattern so you don't unevenly distribute Okay, and now to get started on these brake calipers, get these brake pads out. So I think this one should be a 5 millimeter. Let's see if we get these out. Oh, those are tight. Those were super, super tight. Wow. How'd I do that?
Dang.
Too tight. Massive breaker bar on this little guy. Those were not loose at all. Good to know. Probably been out in a long time. Slide pins. This metal chaining clip comes out, and then the brake pads just fall right out. Just like that. And it's going to be the same process with this side. Crazy tight. I don't think I need to put lock threader in these, but no, it doesn't even look like it. Now to put the new pads in. So here are the new brake pads. As you can see, they are the same which is great. Another thing I was a little worried about, because I wasn't sure if F4 and F4i brake pads were different. But they definitely are the same, and I'm pretty sure these are the same calipers that came with the bike. I'm hoping anyways. So let's see how to get these ones in there. Slide in pretty easy. I do have to spread that piston open though. I won't be able to get the rotors on, so if I use an old pad, two old, yeah, both the old pads. That might be enough clearance in there. Hoping. It's pretty close. So open them up a little bit more. See if I'm actually gonna put the other ones in. And then pry it a little bit more. Alright. That seemed to do the trick. Definitely wide enough. So let's put those new pads in. Now we gotta face this clip up. It says up on there. And then put these slide pins right back in. Snug that one up a little bit. Get this side through. We can tighten those up a little bit better once it's back on the bike. Then I'm going to do the other caliper the same way, and then we'll be putting the wheel back on. got the fender on. I get this thing back on the ground. Now we just gotta finish tightening up this axle.
And that is the front brakes for you guys. Hopefully the next video that comes out will be part three of this. I'm going to be putting the rear one on, the new pads, the rear rotor and the new pads for that caliper. And I also have to install the new clutch cable I have upstairs. When I end up doing that video, I'm going to take all these plastics off and redo all the bolts, because I got a whole new brand new bolt kit to get rid of all these really stinking sharp bolts for the fairings. And that's pretty much it. I don't think there's any fluid in there. There's a little bit, but I don't know if it's gonna do anything yet. Oh, there it is. Kind of getting tight. Oh, yeah. I got brake fluid for this as well. But, that is the front brake pads and rotors for 2001 to 2006 CBR 600. But it's also the same for the F4 and the F4i. I guess they're both the same. But, I'll see you guys in the next one.